Hi everyone, this is Koneko. I'm going to showcase this Nikaya. Well, she's a Genesis unit. And even though she's a Genesis unit, but she already have the 6th gate. And I managed to max her 2nd and 5th gate. The rest of her gate I only up to 2. And then with the gear everything and the runes, her overall status is okay, but the magic attack is not bad. And then the speed is quite high. And then for her leader skill, as you can see, there are 2 types of attack up. One is a pierce attack up 20% and one is a magical attack up 20%. And then with the accuracy up. But if you max her 3rd gate, the magical attack up become all attack up, so that all of the pierce attacker will have 40% attack, or all other attacker will have another 20%. So this leader skill is very good for all light unit that is using the pierce attack. And then for her main ability, for this first skill, it is a panel trap. And for the one turn, whoever touched the panel will have the slow status plus accuracy, evasion, and speed greatly down for 3 times. And her evasion greatly up. So this trap panel is quite good, especially it is a center area. So whoever is near her, they will have the debuff and then they will have a bit trouble on her. Okay, for the second skill, it is an area light magic attack with strong blind status. So basically it is an attack plus a blind status and then reduce their evasion and accuracy at the same time. Quite good. And then if you master her 5th gate, it added extra speed and light resistance down for 3 turns. And the shooting range increased by 1. And also the skill usage increased. Quite good actually. And then for the 3rd skill, it is an area buff panel. And whoever is within the panel will have the HP regen and jewel regen plus all evasion up except for shooting attack. And it will be disappeared for some period, but the only problem about this panel is only the flying unit will have this effect. So other than flying unit like Nikaya and Kadanoba, nobody will have this buff effect. Maybe in future they will release more flying unit, but then for now only Nikaya and Kadanoba will have this effect, of course within the panel. And then for the 4th skill, it is an area light pierce attack and only the enemy will getting the damage with the property of critical and CT half. And if the opponent have the accuracy or evasion down, the skill power greatly increase. Plus for the one turn, she will have the speed greatly up and jewel cost 0. Well, this is really a very powerful skill, since if the opponent have the evasion or accuracy down, after using this skill, you can use this skill for free. And then for the last skill, it's a barbell skill and you need to level up to level 85, which is max break everything. And then for the 3 turns, she'll have the accuracy, pierce attack, and critical rate up. And then for the skill above, they will not have any skill usage. So basically, after activate this skill, the 4th skill, you can use 6 times total. 6 times. And then you can use this skill for free after the first attack. Interesting. And then for the side ability, for this first skill, it switch position with any target. So nothing much, but you only can use 1 time. And then for the second skill, it is a moving light pierce attack and with the property of critical and strong versus the flying unit and also interrupt the jump attack. So basically this skill is more on interrupt the jump skill attack. And then for the 3rd skill, it is a debuff panel with all attack down. So whoever is touching the debuff panel will have the all attack down and it will disappear after 3 times. And then for the last skill, it is an area bind and this status attack. So even though it's only just a status attack, but at least it's an area status attack, but the range is only just in front of her 3x3, so beware. And then for the ration skill, well, this ration skill will activate any types of attack. And then before the opponent attacking her, she will activate for the 2 turns pierce attack speed and slash evasion rate up, and can be stacked 2 times, and that skill can be elevated. and there's no reach limit. So this reaction skill is almost like Laftalia. Except that Laftalia is all evasion up, but this is only slash evasion up. So she's very good in evade on slash attacker. Okay, next is the passive. This passive is when she masters the second gate, it adds extra the magic attack up and increases the beat speed plus skill usage plus 1. So it's good to master her second gate to increase her magic attack. And then next is... this is another passive from her main job. It increases her pierce attack and magical attack up plus accuracy up. So these two passives will be the best for her. And then next is the mementos. Well, this mementos is a limited mementos. And then for the good skill, well, it increases the magic attack and maximum jewel, okay. And the last good skill is quite good. It increases the light attack and accuracy and slash evasion up. So she's really very good in evade on all of the slash attackers. It is something like Yara's. And then if you max break her mementos, her skill jewel cost will reduce by 15%. Actually not bad. And then for the visual ability, it is an aerial light pierce attack. And for the 5 turns, her magic attack up. And then if you max break these mementos, the overall skill power attack increase, as well as the magic attack up become permanent buff instead of 5 turns. But then the magic up buff is only 30%. So even though it is a permanent buff, but it's only just a 30%, but it's better than nothing, of course. And then for the gear, this weapon is from her mementos. Okay, it increases her magic attack and light attack. Okay, quite good. And then with the blind resistant and strong versus a fly unit. And for the weapon ability, it is an aerial magic attack and it moves the opponent 5 square in front of her. So basically this skill main purpose is move the enemy into the debuff panel. And then you use her 4th skill for the maximum damage. Quite nice. And then if you don't have this weapon, you can change to... this accessory is from the Zyne Limited Mementos. It also increases the magic attack and then with the dark resistance and accuracy up, plus you can use the weapon ability, it fully recovers her HP. But then if you don't have this accessory, you can switch to this accessory as well. This is a free accessory you can get from the Teona quest, like Olympic quest. And then it also increases the magic attack and sun speed and HP. So this will be the good alternate choice for the free gear. And then next is... this armor is from the Tamamo Mementos. Well, it greatly increases her HP and also increases a bit physical defense and jewel gain. But if you don't have this armor, you can switch with... this accessory is from one of the 4-star mementos. It also increases the HP and then with the initial jewel up. But best part is, it have jewel regen and also HP regen for the weapon ability. So basically, this accessory is very good for her as well. And then another alternate choice is... this free armor you can get from the tutorial quest. It also increases the HP and then with a bit jewel gain, but also have the HP regen for the weapon ability. So these are the best alternate choice for the armor. Okay, next gear is... this accessory is from the gear summon. Well, it increases the speed and slash evasion. So with this accessory, her slash evasion will be further increased. And then you can use the weapon ability. It is a moving skill and recover her best status, and for the 3 turns, her speed will increase. Well, this weapon ability is not bad since it's a moving skill. And then if you don't have this accessory, you can change to... this accessory is from the Tamamo 3 Mementos you can get from her Job Plus event. And it also increases the speed as well as maximum jewel plus 20 and luck plus 50. Okay. Well, overall it's not bad as a free accessory. Okay, next is, I'm going to try out at the training arena and let's see all of her skill attack damage is how much. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's check her status first. Well, with her leader skill, her overall status is this high and with the Mementos good skill as well. But anyway, let's see her normal attack first. As you can see, her attack range is 1 and 2. Since she's a lance user, let's see the normal attack damage. Okay, and then this one. Okay, not bad. And with the blood status, and this one. Well, as you can see, AoE is a one straight line, but it's okay. And this is an instant cast, and the damage, okay. And the side ability, this one. Okay, not bad. And the master ability. This is from her Memento skill, weapon ability. Let's see the damage. Okay, the damage is not high, but the main purpose of this skill, as I say, is move the opponent in front of her when she have the debuff panel surrounded by her, so that the opponent will have the debuff. And then this is from her Memento's BJ ability. Let's see the damage. Okay, nothing much. Okay, next is if the opponent have the accuracy or evasion down, let's see this skill attack increase by how much, as well as the speed increase by how much for herself. Okay, let's go. Okay, as you can see, the debuff panel is really that big. And then let's see the damage increase by how much. Okay, nice. And then if I use this skill, she have the speed up and jewel cost zero. Let's see the speed increase by how much. Whoa, for the one turn. Nice. And then out of her skill, you see zero. So basically, if the opponent have the debuff, you can keep using this skill until there's no usage. But of course, if you are smart, you can use this skill first. After that, you can use more of this skill and repeat with the jewel cost zero. Nice. And also reduce the CT half. So this is really a very good skill. And next is, if the opponent have the light resistance down, let's see all of her skill attack increase by how much. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's see her normal attack first. Okay, increase a bit only. And then this one, really a bit, nothing much. And this one, okay. And this one, okay. And then this one, nothing much. Lastly, this one, okay. Okay, next is if she have the magic attack up, let's see the overall damage increase by how much with everything, of course. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's check her status first. Well, it's only just 30%, so nothing much. But let's see her normal attacks first. Okay, it's only a bit. Seriously. And then this one. Okay. And this one. At least this skill managed to hit 21k. Quite nice. And this one. Okay. And then this one. Okay. Lastly, this one. Nothing much. Okay, lastly is if she have this pierce attack up, let's see her overall damage increase by how much with all the buff and then with the resistance down as well. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's see the normal attacks first. Okay, a bit. And this one, I wonder. Whoa, 23k, but only up a bit by looks, but at least increase the accuracy and critical rate. And then this one, okay. And this one, also nothing much. Okay, let's see the damage of this skill when criticals. Whoa, 33k, nice. So if her magic attack is more than 3k with the help of Mota, I think the damage should be insane. Well, as for this Nikaya, even though she is something like a support unit, but then her 4th skill is really like a super DBS skill. Seriously. So not only she is very good in reduce the opponent accuracy and evasion and all attack debuff or anything like speed debuff, like resistance down, but then she also very good in attacking, especially if the opponent have the accuracy or evasion down. Basically, you can use the skill unlimited without any jewel cost with the help of the Burbell skill, the last skill. Seriously. she's really a very good red boss killer. But provided the red boss doesn't have any immune on accuracy or evade debuff. But other than that, it's really good enough since it also reduces the CT and with the property of critical. And that as her mementos. It's not a compulsory for her, but of course with the mementos she'll be more powerful. But there's no leader skill for Genesis so fast. And then the only thing you need to do something about her is you need to collect a lot of her shards to train her and Kaigan her so that she'll be very strong. Otherwise, her HP is really very low without the Kaigan status. Okay, so that's all about Nikaya. Thank you for watching this video. If you guys got any questions about her, please comment. Please thumbs up and subscribe if you like this video. See ya, sayonara.
私は平気です。皆さんは大丈夫ですか？